Ora baba basha kadara la brada bada shikidi. Dora baba baba basha kidi bro don kora bakara bodur shokura. Father, we just thank you this evening. We thank you this morning. God, we just praise you for your spirit that lives within us, teaching us in every area, teaching us how to live, teaching us how to walk. For Lord, your word declares that we walk by faith and we walk not by sight. So Father, I come to you now in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior of my life, and Lord of Crossroad Christian Church. I thank you this morning for the time that we have together with other believers. It's not by coincidence or by accident that we are here. But we have an appointment with you. But we're here seeking your face and not your hand. We are here to hear from you concerning your kingdom, your way of doing things. This is your territory, and we allow you to be ruler and reign as king over our lives. So, Father, we just thank you this morning. Thank you, Lord, for also speaking to us concerning ourselves. We are imperfect beings, Lord, that come before a perfect God. Because of this love and mercy, we are not consumed, and your compassions fail us not. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, Lord, we thank you that we humble ourselves with meekness so that we don't have to be humiliated. For your word declares to us that if we humble ourselves, that we don't have to be humiliated by you. So we thank you. So, Father God, I thank you that according to 1 Peter 5, 6, and 7, it says, humble yourselves, therefore, in the mighty hand of God, and that you will exalt us in our due time. So we declare, based on the basis of your word and the faith that you have given us, it's our due time. This is our season to live in victory. This is our season not to walk in fear. This is our season to be able to trust you. God, we just praise you and magnify you. Lord, we lift you up and we just thank you, Father God, for being King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Thank you for being the Alpha and Omega. So, Father God, we declare that based on your word and the faith that you give us, Father God, that we're going to also cast all of our care upon you, for you care for us. That's a promise that we have from you, and we thank you for bringing it into fruition in our lives. I also declare, Father, on the basis of your word, divine health over every member here of Crossroad Christian Church. So it is our divine right. It's our privilege as believers. So your word tells us in Proverbs 4:20-22, attend unto my words, incline an ear unto your sayings, for they are life unto those that find them and health to all their flesh. Isaiah 53:5 tells me that you was wounded for our transgressions, you was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of your peace was upon us, and by your stripes we are healed. So we thank you, Lord, that we believe your word. We believe you, and we stand on it. We stand firm in your word. We cast out fear. We cast out doubt. We cast out unbelief because of the love of God. For your word declares that perfect love casts out all fear. So, Father God, we thank you that your word is our foundation. We thank you, Lord, for creative miracles, limbs growing back, eyes popping open, a missing body parts being restored to normal, all types of cancers being eradicated, diseases known and unknown completely healed. But Father God, your word tells us, Father God, that some people need to see signs, wonders, and miracles in order for them to believe. So Father God, as believers, we believe so that these signs will manifest in every believer's life. Father God, we even thank you, Lord, for even the rapid healing of COVID-19, even though it seems like the world tends to focus more on the negativity and the people that are infected. Lord, we have the truth of the fact there's more in recovery than people that have been lost and people that have died. So we thank you and praise you. Even in the midst of this, Lord, we still have a testimony that we can still trust you and depend on you and rely on you. God, I pray for every kid that was in school, every teenager that was going to school, and people that were in colleges, even though in this tough time, Father God, we know that you're still with us. Well, your word tells us, Father God, that as a Christian, we're built for adversity. So we're thanking you, Lord, for teaching us how to be strength, how to be strong, how to trust, how to rely on you. Lord, we thank you that we'll abide by the mandate and stuff that's been given to us. We thank you that your peace is with us and that we won't walk in fear. And we bide the hands of the enemy, Lord, that's tried to grip this nation in fear. The devil has been. I repeat, has been and not will be, but has already been defeated in our lives. You are King and you are Lord. You are Christ. Hallelujah to the name of God. I thank you, Lord, that even these students, even though in this time, that they will still have their confidence in you. Your word declares that in all your ways, if we acknowledge you, you will direct their paths, our paths, and anybody's paths who decides to trust upon you. So, Lord, I thank you that these students, they do have confidence in you. Lord, from Proverbs 3:5 tells us, if we trust in the Lord with all of our heart and we lean not to our own understanding, we acknowledge you in all our ways, you would direct our paths. Hebrews 10:35 tells us to cast not away therefore our confidence, for it has a great recompense of reward. But I even thank you for even safety of every person that's even during this time, what they call essential workers, whether they're at the gas stations or some type of factory, Father God, that you protect them. Allow your grace to be shown upon them this day, Father God, in this time. Lord, I even believe, and even in this time, that we can trust you that more people will come to the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So, Father God, I thank you for the people that may work in certain areas, Father God, whether it's a public outing or even here at the church. We thank you, Father God, that the enemy's plans, they have been foiled. We interrupt them and we disrupt them and we overthrow them by the power of the living God. Because we choose to pray this morning, Father God, we are taking back what already belongs to us. For your word declares unto us that the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, but the violence taken by force. So we take it back by force this morning. Hallelujah to the name of God. The kingdom, your word says it, Father God, so we thank you. So I thank you for putting righteous men and women in the political arena. I know we says we want to put in there, but Father God, I thank you and I believe you that they're already in the arena, that they'll stand up. That's designed to be a truthful and raise up a righteous standard that won't shun the truth, knowing when to speak and knowing when to be silent, not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. People who can get things accomplished and laws changed, because prayer really does change. It all starts with prayer, and without prayer, Father God, we have nothing. So we thank you. So from the local government to the three branches of the federal government, from the executive branch to the legislative branch and the judicial branch, we are praying not that people be sent to these offices because they're already there. So I'm asking you to give them the boldness to fear you and to trust in you. So give them a discerning heart and a surety that you are with them because of their obedience. So we will see this nation change for a better, and we will stand on that truth. For your word says that we are the salt of the earth, and if the salt loses flavor, where would we be? So we thank you. I thank you, Lord, for giving us as believers a house that we can come to that's safe to serve you freely, a house of worship. I thank you that you meet us here collectively. You meet us where we are, and we give you praise, Lord, for the protocol of this house. It's all about you plus nothing, which gives us everything. Thank you for the leadership and every person's house here to help us fulfill the person that you have given our great pastors. Every person is doing their part, should fill a part. So I thank you, Lord, for the anointing that's on all the auxiliaries here in this house, where people serve you freely, not to be seen of men, but to glorify you. For your word tells us, like I said in the beginning of my prayer, if we humble ourselves, you will exalt us. So it's all about pleasing you, not pleasing men. So Father God, we thank you that this is your house. So we tell you this morning to have your way, and we literally mean it. Have your way. And we thank you for every service that we come in here, whether it's on Sunday, Wednesday, or our prayer service, Father God. We have a high expectation, and we put a demand on the Spirit of God and every department to have an extra spirit so that your excess can flow here in this house. I thank you for the souls that are coming and the ones that are already here that are being rejuvenated. We thank you, Lord, that your words tell us that you are married to us. And as believers, we already know that. So we thank you that you revitalize and you energize to serve you with the spirit of grace so that we can stay delivered. As you develop us in the ways and the flow and the destiny that you've already prepared for us before the foundations of the world. Father, I pray for rest for Pastor Wallace and Margo. Even during this time, we thank you for the strength and the encouragement and the word that you give them. I thank you that they'll continue to put their hearts and trust in you, continue to increase their faith so they will believe in you, so that what may seem impossible does come possible. For your word that says that with men it's impossible, with you all things are possible. So Lord, we thank you for that circle that you have given them to encourage them, to keep believing, not give up, and if possible, to remind them what you've already accomplished in their life. Thank you for restoring their bodies and things that may have seemed lost. Lord, I speak Joel 2:25-27 over our pastor's life, which says you will restore them the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which you have sent among us. They shall eat in plenty and they shall be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord their God. They have dealt wonderfully with them and they shall never be ashamed. And they will know that you are in the midst of them and that you are their Lord their God and none else. And they shall never be ashamed. So thank you, Lord, for prospering them spiritually, mentally, emotionally, and financially. Thank you for blessing their family all the way down to their grandkids. And Father God, I also pray a special growth for the people that may have lost their job or is in the middle, unfortunately, and may be losing some loved one because of the situation, this pandemic that we're in. I pray for strength and encouragement that you would touch them. I pray that their faith will be increased, and if they don't know you, this is the time where they will get to know you, that someone that's of the precious faith and believers, as myself, Father God, will be able to speak a word to them and cause their lives to be changed. I thank you, Lord, that they will be filled with your spirit and your presence, and that they will be example to their family and to anybody else in this situation. I pray for the medical staff, Father God, the hospital workers, the doctors, the nurses, and everyone that's doing their part to try to help people that's maybe going through this. I pray for safety, not just over their lives, but even over their immediate family. I thank you that you've given them jobs where income still come in and that favors upon their lives so they don't have to miss nothing in action. I thank you for strength and boldness. I thank you for even the doctors and the CDC are trying to come together to even come up with a plan and hopefully a cure, Father God, that we'll be able to give these people so that they have a rapid recovery and not have to suffer. And even though we may suffer, Father God, we'll still never suffer like you suffered on the cross of Calvary. So we thank you, Father God, for that. Lord, I thank you even for the leaders of all this nation that you'll intervene with them, from the president down to the governors and everyone that's involved in this situation, that they'll be guided by wisdom, that someone to speak a right now word to them, a faithful word that can be trusted and relied upon, and that the laws will change for your goodness. Father God, we give you faith for doing that and trusting that. Father God, I even thank you, Lord, that I'm praying that this virus will pass away quickly. We know we've been into it maybe a month and a half, and it seems like things are getting increasing, but God, we still trust you. We're going to believe you. We're still going to call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. People are still going to be saved. Lord, I thank you that we're not going to miss. We're not going to want for nothing. For your word tells us in Psalms 23, Father, that you are a shepherd, well, we shall not want. So we thank you that we're not going to want, or that we're not going to lack for anything. And I thank you, Lord, that this will pass away. For your word says, like anything else, that this too shall pass. So we thank you that it is passing in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you that even the future of the world, that people may resolve to come back to their first love, which is you. Sometimes, Father God, it seems like in order for people to know you, that we have to go through certain things. And that's how life is, Father. We realize sometimes we have to be down in the gutters to recognize who our God and our Savior is. And Father God, this may be a bad time, but we thank you that the people that do come to you, they'll recognize to you, and they'll be strong in the faith. They'll be stronger in the faith than they've ever been before in their life. I thank you for this Crossroad family, every member here at this church. Lord, I thank you that, to my knowledge, I've heard no reports of anyone that's sick or even had that. Lord, to me, that's just a testament of your faithfulness, how you're watching over your people to perform your miracle. You're watching over your flock, and you're keeping them safe, Father God. But even though that we're safe, like I said before, we're going to do our part, Father God. We're going to wash our hands. We're going to do the social distance. We're going to trust you and what the government says, but our faith is ultimately in you. So I thank you that even every member of this church is healed, healthy, blessed, and prosperous. I thank you that every member of this church, Father God, and even around the world, that they won't struggle, they won't lack for nothing. This is a time to trust in you, and we won't fear. And Father God, I thank you and I praise you. I give you glory and honor for this evening, Father God. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for the elders and the leaders, how you strengthened them, you encouraged them. I thank you for faithfulness, Father God, that they always have a word, that you even put a word on my heart that we can always speak. I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. I give you praise, Lord. I give you glory. I give you honor, Father God, for what you're doing. And Lord, as I come to a close on this prayer, Lord, my prayer upon this is, may the Lord bless and keep us. May the Lord make his fine face shine upon us, and you be gracious to us. Lift up your countenance upon us and all the members of Crossroad. In Jesus' name, amen.